Okay, who am I interviewing today?
So I'm Abby Salgado.
Your boy Papa Hunter.
Jackson Carter Miserly.
Man, I be the pretty motherfucking man. Hey, Addison Bowen.
I'm John Marsh.
Okay.
Senior.
Marley Nielsen. Police Merkin.
Gabe. We're sitting with Tommy Cook.
Vivian Vasquez.
Ethan Wong.
I care so.
Bailey Herford
and Olivia Gustafson.
Blake Meiser.
Well,
I'm Jay Brown.
This is Lila, and this is Eleanor.
And I'm Lucy.
Natalie Ramsey.
Kristen Burchill.
My name is Ben Hoffman.
Max.
Last name?
Haywood.
Nick Handley.
I'm Blake Sparks.
My name is Cameron Kinsella.
My name is Leland Hess.
My name is Logan Jensen.
My name is Taylor Kolababa. I'm Haley Ann Scholar.
Izzy Moore.
Luke Roberts.
Grace Christensen.
I'm Lindsay.
I'm Ashley.
Jessica Darnell.
Okay, where's Maddie at?
I don't know. Where is Maddie?
Oh, there she is.
If I could use one word to describe my senior year, it'd probably be weird, just because we didn't have school last year. So it's like our first year being upperclassmen, I guess. So it's just weird, like different dynamic, I guess. And I don't know, it went by really fast, so
yeah,
it's weird.
Fantastic. It's just been a great year. Lots of good memories.
Wild. Ups and downs. Crazy. Confusing. Learning a lot of stuff. Growing.
Unpredictable. I would say funky.
Garbage.
Dreadful.
Ass.
Shit.
Okay.
Just gonna be straight up.
Okay.
Fantastic.
Climactic.
Oh, that's
climactic.
Do you feel mature enough to be leaving high school?
No.
Heck no. Heck to the no.
At times, yeah. At other times, no. Really depends on the day. Some days I wake up and I'm like, what am I, like 25 or some shit? And other days I wake up and I feel like a little 5-year-old that wants my mommy. So.
I mean, I feel like I'm ready to get out of here. I feel like, I feel okay. I feel like I'm ready to take on the world like a mature, cool kid, cool adult.
I feel like I'm like mature enough, like, when it comes to like maturity level, but like just I don't know if I'm like fully know like everything I need to, like like living on my own and stuff, and that's gonna be difficult. You know, I don't have to do that eventually, so that's a little scary, but I think I'm mature.
In a sense, yeah. I mean, I still don't know how to do taxes and pay a bill, but I think I can figure it out, but emotionally, I think so.
Yes, but no. I feel like I am ready to go to college, but I feel like I haven't mentally left the high school mindset. I'm kind of scared that I'm going to be wilding out on college campus and it's not going to go well for me. But overall, I feel like I'm pretty ready.
Okay. Can I ask what your plans are for after high school?
I'm going to go to Clackamas Community College and then do a transfer degree and hopefully become an art teacher and shadow for Mr. Rich.
I'm just going to CCC, getting my prereqs done. Pretty boring.
Going to Clackamas Community and just getting credits.
Go to CCC for a year and then I'm going to go to OIT. Try and become a radiologist.
Probably CCC, Clackamas Community College, to get some credits.
Well, I'm gonna attend Clackamas Community College for a couple years, get a transfer degree, and then join this guy.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be studying psychology at the University of Oregon in the fall.
I'm going to U of O. I have no specific major yet. I'm going in very flexible, so I can choose what I want to do, but I'm heading off to college in the fall. So
I'm planning to go to U of O for biology.
I'm planning to go to U of O. I want to go into psychology. I'm not sure what branch of psychology yet, but it's definitely psychology.
I will be attending Oregon State, and I will be a photographer for the wrestling team.
I plan to go to Oregon State University, where I plan to get a master's in chemistry.
I'm going to travel a lot over the summer and dance, but then when it comes to the fall, I'm attending Chapman University, which is in Southern California, Anaheim area, and I'm going to be a dance major attempting to get a BFA.
I am planning on attending college in Massachusetts and continuing cheerleading there.
Portland State, like everyone else.
I'm enrolled in Portland State University for the fall term as a communications major. And after my 4 years at PSU, I hope to get into the journalism field and write for a living.
I'm going to Lane Community College to get a business associate's.
I'm going to try to attend a junior college and play baseball for 2 years and then transfer to a bigger school to get my psychology degree.
Cosmetology, hair.
I'm going to go get my esthetician's license, and that also comes with my makeup license, so I'm gonna do like weddings and events and stuff to pay through school, which I'm gonna go to like either PSU or PCC.
My brother and I are going to start a real estate business.
Oh nice, okay.
And so I'm gonna go to Lowell University, which is where my brother's going, and get an associate's degree in business, and then my brother and I will graduate in the same year.
I want to go into the electrical union because I know some people who have been doing that and it's been working out for them, so I'm hoping to follow in that same path.
Is there anything you wish you did in high school that you didn't?
I wish I talked to more people at the beginning of freshman and sophomore year and made more like connections with people, because I think like COVID took that away and the ability to do that, and then senior year I just full force talked to everybody and I don't regret it at all. I made so many more new friends.
Transfer so many times. I wish I came here my freshman year.
I wish I did more sports.
I wish I waited longer to start working.
I wish I did air band because I never did it, but that's just like really terrifying. I wish, I don't know, yeah. But other than that, I've been involved in like a lot of different things, and like my high school experience has been pretty fulfilled.
I would guess I'd probably say like air band and spirit week and that kind of stuff. I'm not a person that like will put myself out there in situations like that and be like, oh my god, I'm gonna come to school in a crazy costume, but it definitely seems like it would have been fun, and I do regret it a little bit.
What was your favorite year of high school and or your least favorite year of high school?
Least favorite would definitely be last year, junior year, because it was mainly all online, didn't get to see a lot of people, it was COVID and everything like that, so it was just kind of a bummer for the year. And probably my favorite year would be freshman year. It was a big change from eighth grade to here. We had a lot of different like people to meet, a lot of new people. It was a really good time as a freshman, I'd say.
So we were talking about this before the interview, and I said sophomore year, yeah. And you disputed that.
Sophomore year was good. That was like definitely a good year for us, like the two-thirds that we actually had. But personally, my favorite year was freshman year, just because like, you know, coming into high school is such a like surreal experience. Like, heard everyone talk about it all the time, and how different it is, especially from, you know, our middle school, Craftsburg. But I think my most memorable experience with freshman year is the talent show.
That was very good. Yeah.
Very fun, so.
See, I totally agree that freshman year was like, I feel like freshman year and sophomore were the only 2 years we actually had the Gladstone High School experience. Like, and it's totally just drastically changed since COVID, and then obviously makes sense why. But for me personally, sophomore year, you know, you're not a freshman anymore. Like, I had a bunch of older friends, and like I had 2 years with those older friends, and I was just doing more things. The sophomore year for me was definitely the pinnacle for like high school, like classic high school experiences for me. Yeah. Especially at the end there, I was full on high school, like, hey, let's go, everybody, like driving, going to lunch, and then after that.
Yeah.
They've all sort of been the same. So like my freshman year, it started out good, and then like I was going through some stuff towards the end, so it kind of was like not the best, and then sophomore year was like flipped around, so it was like going good, and then just got bad, and then junior year I don't even remember, like it was just on the Chromebooks. Like, I honestly didn't do anything. Like, think about it, like, I didn't do anything. And then this year, I don't know, it was really tough first trimester, and then, like, second trimester was getting better, and now this is just, it's been a great last couple months.
I think my best year, if we're talking just, like, emotionally, was sophomore year, and my worst year emotionally, oh my fucking god, junior year. I might have been gonna get into that, but that was a whole ordeal. But if we're talking like looks-wise, senior year was my year, man. I don't know what the fuck I was doing my first 2 years of high school, but I look at those pictures and I think I would kill that bitch if I could.
Where do you see yourself in a few months, a year, 5 years, or 10 years?
In 5 years, hopefully I graduated from college. That's always the goal. I'd like to have my own apartment or my own place. That would be amazing. Hopefully dancing a lot. I would love to be an intern for Nike or some brand like that where I can do graphic design on the side. Unfortunately, dancers don't make that much money. So I'd love to be doing both of those things.
In a couple months, probably working, just getting money for, because I want to transfer to OSU in 2 years, just like getting money and living a life. In 5 years, I feel like that's hard to like, I don't know, I feel like, just trying to get into nursing school and build my career.
I'd say in 5 years, I'll be like 23, probably still be in school, getting my PhD. Hopefully playing baseball. That's the goal. And I think I'll be pretty happy in 5 years.
Well, in a few months, hopefully I'm at U of O, settled in my dorm, like, got the dorm mates that I wanted, and yeah, just living life at college.
I think in 10 years, be able to have a successful business and have a family and have my own house. I think that's a good goal. I think that's definitely where I want to see myself.
Is there a specific senior that you would like to shout out that has impacted you or has just stuck with you since you began high school?
I have to shout out the cameraman. Cameron, you've always helped me out through the high school experience. You've always had my back, and I feel like our friendship from like freshman year till now has just gotten a lot closer and a lot better.
My man. That's pretty good.
Okay, well, that was pretty easy for Blake.
Man, I didn't think about this, to be honest. Alright, I'll say my buddy Tristan Birchfield. He is somebody I knew very vaguely in middle school, but he's impacted me. He's one of the only people that's actually stuck with me like my entire high school years, and we haven't had some sort of clashing moment. He's just a brother to me, so I definitely would shout him out.
Yeah, I'd say Sammy Fergus. He's grown a lot. Like, we used to be friends in like sixth grade. He never said shit in any, like, ever. And now he's like super like out there and like doing the air band and all that shit. So yeah, definitely him. And we've never been in any fights. Like, always been cool with him. So yeah.
I also like how he's grown out his hair as well.
Yes, his hair is fine.
I think I would probably say Ethan Walsh. We aren't necessarily close friends, but for him, it's always been someone where I could rely on him. I could have a fun conversation. And he taught me a lot about myself that I didn't recognize. And I think that I learned a lot from him as an athlete and as a person. And I kind of learned how to enjoy myself.
Definitely Grace Christensen. She helped me through so much. One of the first people I met when I came to this school. She really impacted me.
Cameron. So been there with me all year. Stuck by my side. Blake, man, that dude just like always brings up the vibe. Like, this track season was amazing with him. I loved our whole team. Glad I got to know Owen a little bit more. Me and him are never really connected before this track season. Towards the end, it was especially fun hanging out with that guy. Like, he's awesome, super smart guy. Jay Brown also just like always brings around the good vibes, like, but also at the same time is serious about like what he wants to do, and I feel like he knows where he's going. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
I don't know, he's just someone I look up to and like aspire to be like. So.
Is there a teacher that has made your experience better here?
Mr. Browning is always funny, and I like his teaching style because it mixes like humor with education, which makes it easier to like learn everything.
Okay. Pearson, just because they were really funny and were really positive and made English and drama really, really fun.
Low key, I'm gonna have to say Arnold, simply because I've had him as my teacher for like 7 years. He's always been like a straightforward guy. He's not like gonna beat around and like, he's gonna get straight to the point. He's gonna tell you what's what, so.
So the first one is Mr. Aker. He was my biology teacher freshman year. And I found out that his dad worked at the high school that my parents went to. And so my parents already knew Mr. Aker and his dad. But yeah, me and Mr. Aker just kind of bonded on a personal level, and it was really nice to bond with the teacher that way. Even though he's the AD now, but he still says hi to me in the hallways, and it's pretty nice. And then my second one is Mr. Nelson. Mr. Nelson is a soccer coach, so I got to know him as a teacher this year and a soccer coach.
I would definitely say Miss Chanel for sure. I had her for like a couple weeks before COVID, and then I had her this year. And she just has made my high school like experience that much better, just knowing her for a couple months. Like, she's just such a bubbly person. Like, she can brighten your day. Like, just
sure.
Being in her class, she'll brighten your day. So, yeah, I love her.
Mr. Ellings. Not for anything spectacular, just for being himself and being such a cool dude. He's got it figured out. I mean, I feel like as far as teaching and having relationships with kids, he's a different tier of teacher.
Yeah.
It's beyond teaching. He's in teaching for something beyond teaching, and if you have had him since freshman year and just, you know, actually built a relationship with him and gotten close with him, you'd know that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he's just an all-out positive dude, no matter what. Even when you can tell he's got his own stuff going on, he still shows up for the students every single day. It's just inspiring. He's a cool dude.
Yep.
Miss Sauce is my CCR teacher, and she's probably like the best person ever. I think we can all agree on that.
Yeah.
She's always there. She's been there for everybody. She's been there for me, and she's the highlight of my week when Wednesday comes around. So.
Is there a hardship that you went through that was kind of a turning point for you during high school?
Yeah, I'm gonna go with the obvious and say COVID. That beginning of COVID, I stopped really texting people. I stopped communicating. I stopped socializing. It was just kind of this like isolation where I was. The routine was the same every day. My sleep schedule was whack. It wasn't very healthy for me, and I'm glad I got out of it, but it was definitely rough when it first happened.
Yeah.
Probably quarantine. It really made me, like, see, I don't know, I kind of just, like, turned my life around that year. I did the best for myself.
I definitely think the junior year going into senior year transition was really hard, because it was kind of that realization that we're not kids anymore, and we have to start focusing on our future and like scholarships, colleges, what we're gonna do with our lives. And I feel like the 2 month period, especially during the beginning of this year, I was torn up. I could not figure out what I wanted to do. It was overall just stressful, but it does get better. It does get better.
Hi. Sophomore year, getting into the vape scene, you know, and did get caught. Hey, I can say like everything now, right?
Yeah, go for
it. Okay, you can catch me that first time, Lopez. Hope you know that. I had it on me. You know that, right? Nice try, bro. Anyways, I got caught, and then we got into the whole quarantine thing, and then bettered myself, stopped all that shit, and better because of it.
I don't know if there was a turning point, but there was a lot of stuff that led up to a change.
Yeah.
I was not the best person going into high school at all, I don't think. And just over time, I started to like look within and like try to see who I was and like think about what I really want to be like and who I want to be, and definitely made some changes there. Like, I would notice new stuff all the time, and I'd be like, okay, maybe I don't want that, or maybe I do want that, and I want to keep it. So yeah, it was just a gradual thing, just getting older and maturing.
Is there anything you learned throughout your life experiences or educational experiences that will help improve your life after you graduate?
Watch what you say, because 9 times out of 10, people are not scared to bitch slap you.
But not everybody is who they say they are. And that is a big factual statement right there. Because you can think that you know somebody, but then they do something totally different from what you think they do.
For me, it was learning to trust other people and like open up and be just slightly more vulnerable. Something that, I mean, none of us like doing, and I find it way easier just to lie about how I'm doing. People, oh, how are you doing? Oh, great, how about you? Just turn it right back on them right away. And so from that, and I mean, there have been a lot of other things kind of along those lines, but learning to trust other people, learning to be more honest with them in terms of how I'm doing, honest with myself about how I'm doing, because it's really easy when you're lying to others about how you're doing, to lie to yourself about how you're doing. And it's still something I'm working on. It's not like I've mastered it or figured it out or anything, but it's something that I'm still working. It's a work in progress at this point.
Yeah, I realized something that'll stick with me is that everybody's doing their own thing. Everybody's got their own shit. They all, everybody's thinking for themselves, and you gotta think about what everybody else is thinking about before you do something. Because it really affects them and everything else. So.
What makes our senior class different than past senior classes?
I feel like we touched on it, right? Kind of, we had extremely unique, never happened before high school experience. I would say the end of sophomore year was kind of that, but not really, but like definitely junior year online, like sports seasons were off, like certain things didn't even happen, and like trips were canceled, like so many like things. And so coming into our senior year, it was totally a brand new perspective on like, I guess maybe like the importance and also like the unimportance of like a senior year. Because I feel, you know, normally it's like the trajectory is like you're going to senior year, you're getting excited, you're building up 3 years of build up to like your final year, and we didn't have that time to like, I mean, like mix with each other and like get really excited. And so we came, I think the senior class came in kind of like, school, whatever, like a bunch of people just died of this virus, like in schools. But I feel like we've come back to like realizing the importance of like a senior year. So I feel like most senior classes, I mean, of course I don't really know, but haven't had to have that transition between like really coming to like the importance of the senior year.
Yeah, I was gonna mention that, like, especially towards the end of the year with Spirit Week and everything, we've definitely seen kind of a like a revival of school spirit and like motivation to do something with the community. Like pre-COVID, that was such an area of pride for the senior class. Like they would like win Spirit Week every year, and you'd see just these mass amounts of participation for your class, and it was just really cool to see all the time. And then COVID hit, and you saw that decline in just general just motivation to really, you know, compete and bring people together.
Just care on it.
Yeah.
Like, why should you care about fucking homecoming when like your grandma died of COVID? Or like,
gosh.
But at the same time, it's you got to deal with those hard things. But at the same time, like, why not get involved? You know, you're finally your high school.
Exactly.
Only happens once.
How do you think the younger classmen will affect the school after we're gone?
I'm really hoping that the younger classmen will think that school spirit is cool. It was amazing to see the freshmen get up and do the air band, but it was a little bit sad to see just that many people were worried about, you know, getting up in front of the school and dancing. And as nerve-wracking as it is one of the best things about Gladstone is how we unite through Spirit Week and all make fun of ourselves and do things outside of our comfort zone. So I hope that the younger classmen will kind of drop the egos a little bit and just be willing to be pushed in ways they didn't think they would be able to.
I feel like also, like, just, and this has happened with our class, that the further you go along in high school, the more spirited the kids become. So I'm sure by next year, there's not going to be any less, there's going to be like, yeah, not gonna be any less spirited kids than there are gonna be now in the junior class. Will there be more than now? I don't know, but I don't think there'll be any less.
I think, I don't know, I feel like most people think every year that, oh, well, we're the last class that will keep the school traditions alive. Mm-hmm. But I feel like there's been so many classes that have said that, and the school has stayed Gladstone High School because there's so many traditions that we have, and I feel like the staff and also just the freshmen learning till they're seniors, they all learn the traditions. I feel like they'll keep it as long as the staff keep giving it to them, giving them opportunities to keep those traditions alive.
I feel like a lot of underclassmen especially just think they're too cool for like school or whatever. All like everything that goes on that's school related or Spirit Week, any of that stuff. So hopefully they learn to, I don't know, try and just not act cool just because.
Do you think you fell in love in high school? If you did, what was that like? And if not, still, what was it like not?
I think I fell in love with myself a little bit more. Not in like a narcissistic way at all, but I think I truly learned to love myself and for who I am. And that is more than I could ever have gotten from a partner.
For me at least, I can say I've had a couple relationships in high school, and I think I'll say I thought that I was. I think I've felt, I guess, what love is, but I don't think I fully fell in love during my high school experience, and I'm not sad about that, but it is what it is, you know?
Yeah, and like, I've tried, but, like, after sophomore year, I just stopped because that didn't happen, so I'm not, like, I am disappointed, but I'm not, like...
You don't want to be an incel about it.
That I wish stuff happened, but stuff didn't happen until there's still the rest of life, and I can't get bitches.
It's alright.
I did fall in love in high school, and it was amazing. I guess to go farther off that, I wouldn't recommend it if I wouldn't recommend it if you don't have
any of yourself figured out or you don't have any of your own emotions figured out. But from my own experience, falling in love in high school was maybe one of the most gorgeous, amazing things I could have went through, just the experience itself. Like, in no relation to the person. Like, falling in love is one of the most beautiful things that you can experience in life, and it was amazing.
I definitely had people that I liked, but I never really, like, had any relationships in high school, so.
Okay. Is there a message that you would like to share with the senior class or another option, incoming classes?
Don't take anything for granted, ever. There are going to be times where you feel like the whole world is turned upside down and you don't have anything to look forward to, or you don't have anything to live for. But I think that the second that you slow down, you're gonna recognize just how many amazing things are around you. And I think my biggest regret of high school is taking things for granted. Just be thankful for every single second of every single day.
Be yourself. Do not care what others think about you, because no one gives a fuck. No one cares. You're never gonna see them again. There's some people that you might see again, but no one fucking cares. Everyone's living their own lives. They all have their own issues. They could care less about what shoes you're wearing today and if your socks match or not. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Don't overcommit. Don't undercommit. Try and find that balance. It's one of the hardest things I've done. Still not doing it super well. But don't fully load your plate to the point where you can't get shit done. But also, don't go out there and just not get involved at all. It's one of the greatest decisions I ever made here, was going and getting involved and being a part of what was going on. I just got too into it, so find that balance.
Mine is build really, really, really good friendships that will last through high school, because, like, that's the only constant thing you're gonna have. Like, your classes are gonna change every trimester, obviously, your teachers are gonna change. Like, you can get connected to teachers, obviously, but, like, the only constant you're going to have is your friends. Like, no matter what day you're having, even if you and your boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever broke up, like, whatever's going on, like, you're still gonna have your friends. And prioritize that. Prioritize finding good friendships that aren't gonna drain you, and you'll be set.
Find what's important to you and pursue that. You know, I definitely recommend getting involved and trying new things, and if you hate it, don't do it anymore. But if you find something that you love, keep doing it. I think that I never saw myself being on ASB or doing any of this shit, or like talking at assemblies. Like, that was never something that I saw for myself.
I never saw you doing that either.
I never saw you do that either.
So, I mean, it's a surprise for everyone. So I think that trying new things and pushing yourself can be really beneficial, but also just make sure that you're sticking to what you enjoy and what is important to you. And I think that that's like the best way to find yourself and find what is like good for this part of your life, but also the future.
Seniors, we are moving on to the next stages of our life, and I think it's easy to settle sometimes, you know? And so I just really want to instill like a idea of just going for it. No matter what you're doing, if you go to college, if you get a job, like if you move across the country or move across the world, or you stay in Gladstone, just keep exploring, keep learning, keep being interested, and therefore being interesting, you know? Just don't settle in your lives, you know? Even if your life is amazing, you know, there's still, you could make it even more amazing. Or if your life's really shitty, like, just, I don't know, I always fear for just people in general that, like, just they settle. I've seen it a bunch of, from older kids who used to go to Gladstone High School. I'm like, he used to have, like, so much energy and excitement. It feels like he just kind of, like, this is who I am now, I'm just doing it. Like, you can do that, but at the same time, you also have to be able to, like, change and grow and learn and just explore. I think explore, you know, a seems to be my topic of the day. The word that stuck in my head is explore. So just keep exploring, keep looking for new, interesting, and exciting things. Man, yeah, just go for it, you know?
It's actually kind of weird to think about now. Like, we've been with the senior class since sixth grade, and like just seeing, I don't know, like just sitting there with each other and seeing each other grow over the past, what, like 7 years now?
Yeah.
6 years, 7 years? It's just been very surreal. Like, I'll look back at old photos and like how tiny of children we were.
There are some photos of us that are, sorry, there are some photos of us that are absolutely adorable.
Yeah, literally like freshman orientation day.
Oh, that's the best.
Just like this, I'm hitting the pose like that. But no, it's been crazy. Like, and for underclassmen, like, you know, especially like freshmen, sophomores, these staff members and these upperclassmen are always going to tell you like, time flies, and high school is going to pass you by. And that's very true. Like, we've experienced that. I mean, even though COVID kind of put the year to a halt and then things kind of seem to just move on by without us, you know, we're in our senior year and we've only had like really one true like high school year. Yeah, just take that info into account and trying to enjoy high school to the best of your ability and participate, have fun, encourage each other to just get out there and do new things, explore, and just enjoy your time here, because that's definitely what we're